Now I will talk on neuropathic osteoarthropathy. Neuropathic osteoarthropathy, it is a spectrum of bone and joint destructive process associated with neurosensory deficit. Causes of neuropathic osteoarthropathy are, nowadays most common causes, diabetes mellitus. Other causes are syringomyelia, spinal cord tumors, meningomyelosis, extensive compression of the spinal cord, peripheral nerve tumors, multiple sclerosis, congenital insensitivity to pain, hereditary, sensory and motor neuropathy. Coming to the pathophysiology of neuropathic arthropathy, there are two theories, neurotraumatic theory and neurovascular theory. According to neurotraumatic theory, absence of normal protective sensory feedback results in repeated mechanical trauma causing progressive joint destruction. According to neurovascular theory, loss of sympathetic tone to the limb resulting in vasodilatation and hypermia, and that promotes the bone resorption, and that bone resorption results in the weakened subchondral bone and neuropathic changes are seen. Radiologically, there are two types, hypertrophic one and atrophic one. Hypertrophic joint is manifested radiologically as joint destruction and fragmentation, osteosclerosis and large osteophyte formation. Osteophytes formed in the setting of a neuropathic arthropathy may differ from those of osteoarthritis by early production of ill-defined and rounded margins, later attainment of enormous size, and difficult to distinguish neuropathic osteoarthropathy from severe arthritis in some cases. Atrophic type is seen in usually upper limbs, the bone is completely resorbed, joint is absorbed. More common in the non-weight-bearing joints of the upper extremity associated with the syringomyelia and peripheral nerve lesions. Atrophic type is similar to septic arthritis type in radiologically. Hypertrophic type is similar to severe form of osteoarthritis radiologically. Neuropathy can cause fractures also. Important although less well-known manifestation of neuropathic osteoarthropathy occurs spontaneously or in presence of a minor trauma. Typically, these fractures are transverse in orientation, often initially unrecognized, heal with an exuberant and bizarre callus formation. Upper extremity neuropathic osteoarthropathy. Neuropathic osteoarthropathy in non-weight bearing joints of the upper extremity is relatively rare than the lower extremity. Most common cause of neuropathic shoulder arthropathy is syringomyelia. The patients will present with shoulder mass due to fluid distension of the glenohumeral joint and subacromial subdeltoid bursa. May be confused with the tumor matrix and radiographs. Imaging features that help differentiate soft tissue tumors from neuropathic arthropathy of the shoulder include amputated appearance of the proximal humerus, dislocation or subluxation, large joint effusion, fragmentation centered at the joint with the osseous involvement of on both sides of the joint. In tumor, it will be usually on one side. Other causes of neuropathic arthropathy in non-weight-bearing joints of the upper extremity are leprosy and diabetes mellitus. Leprosy is nowadays less common, diabetes mellitus is more common. It attacks the skin, leprosy attacks the skin and peripheral nerves. Characteristic involvement of the small bones of the hands and feet, usually due to trauma, secondary bacterial infection, superimposed or denervated tissues. Radiological findings similar to those caused by other conditions. Deformity such as claw hand, claw toes and associated with the development of concentric bone atrophy. Neuropathic arthropathy of the shoulder. Neuropathic arthropathy of the shoulder is a chronic progressive process characterized by joint destruction in the presence of neurosensory deficit. Causes include syringomyelia, syphilis, diabetes, chronic alcoholism and leprosy. With the syringomyelia, accounting for the vast majority of the upper extremity chalcoid joints. Early presentation of this rare condition includes non-specific symptoms such as swelling, erythema, sensory symptom and decreased functionality, making a diagnosis challenging. Spontaneous ruptures of the distal biceps and rotator cuff tendons secondary to syringomyelia. orthopedic surgeon should maintain a high index of suspicion for neuropathic etiology in the setting of relatively traumatic tendon ruptures in otherwise healthy young patients. Neuropathy can affect spine also. Thoracic lumbar junction is the most frequently affected area. Usual causes of axial neuropathy are traumatic spinal cord injury, inadequately treated syphilis, amyloidosis, congenital insensitivity to pain, and occasionally diabetes mellitus. X-ray changes are disc space narrowing, vertebral lysis or sclerosis, subluxations, abrupt curvature, open paraspinal soft tissue calcifications, and large hypertrophic endophyte osteophytes are seen. Coming to the lower extremity. Nowadays, diabetes mellitus is a most common cause. It usually affects foot and ankle area, occurs with a long-term poorly controlled diabetes. Neuropathy changes in the feet of diabetic patients may be precipitated by minor trauma. Soft tissue swelling, warmth and erythema are seen, often begins in the midfoot. Subluxation usually starts at second tarsal metatarsal joint and proceeds laterally. Neuropathic injuries of the lower extremities can occur in children also. Charcot arthropathy of the lower extremity is usually treated by non-operative treatment with a cast or brace, something which is non-operative. Non-operative treatment with the use of a total contact cast followed by appropriate bracing and foot wear is the so-called gold standard for the treatment of neuropathic fractures and dislocation of the foot and ankle. Sometimes surgery is required, but it is associated with a lot of complications. Worsening of the foot alignment over time supports the need for aggressive intervention, conservative bracing or surgical fixation to attempt to prevent limb-threatening complications. If the deformity worsens, joint is dislocated, then patient will develop pressure sores and infection. Charcot neuroarthropathy of the foot and ankle. The primary indication for surgery are recurrent ulcerations, substantial deformity, deep infection, and pain is usually rare. Common complications include non-union, wound breakdown, and infection. The principles of thorough joint preparation, deformity correction, and minimizing soft tissue trauma are essential when arthrodesis is performed, which requires more robust fixation and prolonged offloading. After doing a surgery, you have to immobilize the limb for longer period of time. Realignment and extended fusion with the use of a medial column screw for midfoot deformities secondary to diabetic neuropathy. Surgical reconstruction of a collapsed neuropathic foot deformity is technically demanding, but a successful outcome can result in a plantigrade foot that is free of ulceration and abnormal pressure points, and patient who is able to walk. Well-planned reconstructive surgery can create a stable plantigrade foot that remains free of ulceration. Coming to the conclusion, nowadays diabetes mellitus is a common cause of neuropathic arthropathy. Keep in mind, neuropathy, if there is a destruction of the joint, painless destruction of the joint, especially in the upper limb, then think of syringomyelia or some other neuropathy. Treat conservatively as far as possible. Properly planned and executed surgery can give a good results in some patients with a Charcot's joints.